Hey guys, and welcome back to Battlefront updates and some more Bespin content. In the other videos I uploaded, I went over all the new content coming to the game in the Bespin DLC, but in this video I wanted to go over all the changes made to the content that is already in the game, since there's been a ton of improvements, buffs, game mode changes and so on that will be introduced in the Bespin DLC patch. Chances are that the full patch notes for these are gonna come out on the 21st, but I had a chance to talk to some of the developers about the changes directly, so I thought I'd go over them one by one right now. Some of these changes I can show you with gameplay from the event, but I didn't have time to record all of them, so a few of them are just going to be from the mouth of the developers. But now, let's get straight into it. First off, we have the game mode changes. Some game modes, such as Drop Zone, has a special modified version running in the Bespin DLC to fit with the 32 player limit. In this version you actually have 3 drop pods active at once instead of 1, which makes a lot of sense as 32 players going to 1 pod would have been absolute chaos. Moving on, we have Fighter Squadron, which has had its score cap increased to 400, making the rounds much more enjoyable, and right now it doesn't feel like the round ends after 2 minutes. Another addition you might have seen in the Bespin Fighter Squadron is the fact that there's actually Tibana gas platforms to fly around. This makes the game mode a lot more fun in my opinion, as you have cover to fly around and dodge enemies with, as compared to the other maps where everything is just open. Lastly, we have a big update to Droid Run. We never got the chance to play Droid Run at the event, but according to Dennis, the game mode is now based on collecting points instead. Whenever one team manages to capture all 3 droids, the team will start to gain points, and as soon as you hit 100, your team wins. The droids are also a lot quicker to capture, which means that capturing 3 droids won't be as hard as before. This means that even if you have 99 points in one team, the other team can still win as long as they take the 3 droids and hold them. This sounds like a fantastic change, as I pretty much never play Droid Run right now. The way it worked before was kind of useless, as if you didn't capture all 3 droids and hold them for 20 seconds, you had to wait until the end of the round, but now you can slowly collect points over the course of the game. I'm excited to see how this plays out, and hopefully it will become a bit more popular after the patch. Now over to some general changes. After the Bespin patch, you will be able to deactivate charge cards. This means that it won't be as easy to predict when someone's bubble disappears, but now you'll actually be able to turn that personal shield or ion shot off whenever you want to. Friendly heroes will now show up through walls, showing both which hero it is and how much health it has left. This is to promote team play and allow people to actually follow and protect their heroes. So far it has been quite hard to see your own heroes, but now you will be able to actively seek them out. Another very cool feature they added in order to promote team play is that if you're within a specific radius of your partner, your star cards will actually recharge a lot faster, as indicated by the yellow outline. I noticed that it made a huge difference, and I often found myself sticking close to my partner just because of that. I asked the developers how this would be for people who don't play with friends, and they said that they have improved the automatic partnering system to make sure that you always have a partner, which is good to hear because it would have been very unfair otherwise. The bowcaster has been completely remade and now fires 5 shots in more of a circle instead of firing them in a horizontal line. A good change, as it is now a viable weapon to use for longer ranges in corridors and so on, and it won't be as effective user from the air since you need to hit them straight on. The scan pulse has also been remade, and instead of doing one pulse with a lasting effect, it now pulses multiple times when activated, giving you a quick glimpse of the enemies every time. This makes it more of a tactical tool where you can predict where the people are coming, instead of making it like a wall hack where you can see exactly where they are at all times. The pulse cannon has now finally been nerfed against heroes, which is fantastic news, as you won't be able to die in like 2 seconds in Hero Hunt anymore. And on top of that, it made a cool little tweak to the pulse cannon that makes the weapon glint a bit if it's charged up and aiming towards an enemy, as you can see by this guy who is about to shoot me. This means that you will be able to see people from afar who are about to shoot you with the pulse cannon. You won't have much time to react, but in some situations it might help you survive. The explosive shot has been modified and nerfed a bit. I didn't get a chance to try it out, as I didn't know it was changed until after the event, but as far as I understand, it now affects your overheat, meaning that if you pop your explosive shot, you can't fire for as long as normal. Hopefully this will make it a bit more balanced and not as spammy in game modes like Hero Hunt. The Berserker trait has now been nerfed a bit, as many in the community has requested. I loved using the trait, but it was understandable that it would get nerfed. After the patch, you will have to be at under 80% health to actually get the Berserker bonus, which means that you can't just get hit by a Deoxys grenade or step in the lava to get the bonus damage. On top of that, the 50% damage reduction at trait level 3 isn't activated until you're under 80% health, which means that if you get hit by a pulse cannon now, you will die, as the first shot that takes you below 80% won't get any damage reduction at all. Lastly, we have something I know a lot of people have been waiting for, more skins. For the Imperials, they have changed around the system with Palpatine's guards. Instead of having shock troopers, he will now have his awesome red royal guards with him, and the shock troopers will instead be an unlockable skin for the Imperials. I saw a lot of people suggesting this exact change in the community, so maybe that's where they got the inspiration from. As for the Rebels, they have gotten a similar change, as Leia's old honor guards have now become an unlockable skin, and Leia now has her all-around honor guards by her side with the iconic helmets. They have also added an extra skin to the Rebel side, which is the Bespin wing guards that can be seen in the Empire Strikes Back on Bespin. Finally, there has been an improvement made to the score feed, as you can now see more details on each kill, including what you actually kill them with. This is a welcome change, as sometimes you weren't really sure what you actually killed the enemy with, especially if you had put out power-ups all over the map. But well, that brings all the gameplay changes to an end. As you can see, there has been quite a lot of improvements and changes made to the game, so it's not only for the DLC owners that the game will feel different. Chances are that there are a couple of more things that will be revealed in the patch notes, but this should be the main changes made to the game, according to the developers. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to drop a like, and if you have any questions, just leave a comment below. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, may the Force be with you.